All right, we've lost him. Let's begin CPR.
In the simulation lab, we have all types of mannequins that we can use. Sometimes they're just torsos and we're practicing skills. We can move towards a vital sim where they can feel the pulses and actually take vitals, but they won't talk back. And then we move to the 3Gs, where that's the Cadillac, where we can see them actually blinking their eyes and breathing. We can make them sweat, we can make them bleed. When they go to do like a neuro assessment, their pupils will actually react for them. So it's as real as we can get it without being a live human being.
They're really very high tech. It's pretty cool just what they can do. Like, you see their chest rise and fall, and that's pretty neat. And if we do CPR on them, it can record how many pumps per second you're doing or per minute. It'll give you information back that you normally wouldn't get from a regular patient.
I really enjoy working in the simulation lab. I think it really prepares you for when you do go out into the hospital setting. Your instructors can talk through the mannequins, they can change the vitals, and we work with them and do everything that we would do out in the hospital and out in the real field.
Here in the sim lab, I am behind the window, and as you can see these computers along here, I can see what the students are doing, and I, as the instructor, have set standards of what I want to happen in the scenario. I can see everything. I can see that they forgot to wash their hands. I can see that they didn't listen to lung sounds correctly, and I can go out and I can coach them, and that's that teachable moment that you can gather and get them and collaborate with them in a positive way so they can learn. So just remember, everything that happens today, if you make a mistake, it's a learning experience. We have a debriefing room where we go in after a scenario and we watch the scenario and then talk about it. And sometimes that debriefing session is all about reassuring them that they're okay and that they're not going to do this out in the real environment. They learned it here, and so now they can go on and be a safe nurse.
The simulation lab brings about a lot of advantages. I have the instructor support, I have all my peers that are watching me on video, and it's a safe environment where I can make a mistake.
You remember the mistakes you made, and we're making them on mannequins, and that's great. That's the best place to make mistakes, on a mannequin.
The simulation lab is an essential part of our curriculum. The respiratory care program is not one of those programs that you can just learn in the classroom. Coming in here and actually going through all of the steps that what you would really do on a real patient and seeing a full body in bed really prepares students for when they get into the hospital and they do all of these procedures. It's much easier and it's not so nerve-wracking.
Whether they're taking care of a baby or an adult, they get to experience things that are not always seen in clinical. Me as a teacher can see the growth and can see the learning. I believe that the simulation team here at Hawkeye is really striving for excellence and teaching our students the scenarios and giving them the experience where they can go on and be successful in the real world.
So many of the nurses I've worked with have come from Hawkeye, and they're just amazing, and that is what I want to be, is just like them.